Honorable Minister Shri Venkaiah Naidu ji, our creator, TRA Chairman Sharma ji, our preserver, and I hope we don't have a destroyer in this audience. Also, my fellow colleagues from CII and the media industry on the dais and in the audience. It's only in a democracy that you can have a box and wire installer deliver a keynote address in an audio to an audience like this, because we are normally the lower caste amongst the media and entertainment industry. The Brahmins are and collect 200 rupees, 300 rupees, and we are the lower castes.
The lower caste is the most favorite nowadays in politics.
You're right, sir. I hope I continue to remain your favorite by the end of the speech.
Right.
But like I said, you know, we go to every home and we collect 200 rupees and listen to their problems. So we probably speak on behalf of the customer. We are also responsible for monetizing what the industry produces, collecting it from the customer and passing it on back to the government and the content creators. So we are the conduit, really. So that way, I don't really represent just the installer, but also the industry to that extent. I saw the theme somewhere, it said disruption. And I thought it was way too early for us to introduce disruption in industry, because disruption, like in Maslow's hierarchy, is a very higher order action. It requires the fundamentals to be fixed before you approach disruption, because in the absence of fundamentals being fixed, disruption can actually lead to destruction. And that's my fear. And let me state why I fear that. Our Honorable Prime Minister has constantly been saying that we need to make it easy for business to do business. We have to create a single window, and so that the business does not keep moving from window to window, trying to get their permissions, and they focus on the act of doing the business. I'll just give you four or five examples. There's a long list, but I'll just give you four or five examples. We'll just tell you the state of the fundamentals. The industry used to pay 30% of its top line, not bottom line. Bottom line, we've not even reached. I mean, we are 11 years old. We haven't still returned 1 rupee to our investors. We used to pay 30% by way of license fees, taxes to states and center. We've been approaching the ministry for some relief. TRAI itself has recommended first a 6% instead of 10%. Then they whittled it down to 8%, which is also 2.5 years ago, and it's not been implemented yet. In the meanwhile, the taxes that we pay on our top line have moved from 30% to 35%. They're growing at the rate of about 2 percentage points per year. When we go to procure a satellite from the Department of Space to transmit our content, DOS gives us a permission, but we still have to go to the DOT, the NOCC, the MIB, everybody else for the permission, but DOS starts charging us rental from the day they give us the piece, regardless of whether it takes us 5 months, 6 months, 7 months to get the permissions. Since we are a loss-making company, every year my investors have to infuse more equity into my business. Even that requires equity infusion by the same investors requires a permission from the MIB. That file keeps moving from MIB to Ministry of Law to Ministry of Finance just to give me permission to infuse more equity into my loss-making business. It has taken up to 8 and 9 months to get that permission to infuse. In between, I have to go to the market and pick up debt at 11 and 12% to bridge the gap. If I have to take an approval for appointing a new director on the board, despite the fact that he's directors on other boards, it still has to go back to MHA via the MIB for permission. The last permission I got a month ago was after 2 years of appointing a director. The poor man was sitting outside the board for 2 years and was allowed permission to sit in my first board meeting last week. If I have to hire an Indian expat, a man who studied in India, brought up in India, went abroad, learnt new technology, worked with new technology, can come back and disrupt my systems, I still have to take permission. First of all, I'm not even allowed because my license allows it to me, but the FDI conditions don't allow, so I have to go to DIPP, and that never comes. The holding limits for broadcasters on platforms are fixed. You increase the FDI limits from 49 to 74 to 100. You can increase it to 120, but FDI has not flown and may not flow, because what you're encouraging is financial investors who have a short-term vision. You're not encouraging strategics to come into the business. They have a longer-term vision. They understand the business. They have experienced it elsewhere in the world. We want them. We don't want financial experts. And two operators in the country have been operating without a license. The existing license conditions expired 2 years ago. The TRAI has made recommendations to the ministry for the new license conditions 2.5 years ago. Still, there is no... Our license is expired. For a year or so, we were operating without a license. And we have now been issued a temporary license on one pager, which will expire in March 17. So, looking at all this, I don't think the fundamentals are in place. So, it's difficult for us to think about disruption. How is the industry structured? The digitization bill was passed by the parliament 5 years ago on November 11th. Because the existing cable was neither offering choice to the customer, nor was it sharing the money that they collected from the customer to the stakeholders, that is the government and the content producers. DTH, direct to home, on the other hand, was digitized always, is digitized, and will remain digitized. We have no litigation with any broadcaster. Some of them are competitors to my investors. Yet, all my contracts with them get signed, extensions get signed way before the previous contract expires. I contribute 1/3 of the revenue that I make from the customer to the government, another 1/3 to the broadcaster, and left with the 1/3 through which I run my business and grow the business. The customer records are completely transparent and auditable by anybody. You can become a customer by paying rupees 1600, and the moment you pay 1600, I have subsidized you by 3500 rupees. I trust you with that money because I have faith in my service and I know that you will not go anywhere. And I am strengthening that constantly. You get free repair for the year. You can add or drop a channel at will instantly, whenever you want to. You can switch off by recharging because it's a totally prepaid system. When you come back again by recharging, you are not take no penalties imposed on you for not being a customer for some time in between. Any cable platform, analog or digital, cannot claim any one of the above facilities that I've spoken about just now. It's not because of the technology that I use. It's essentially because the absence of a basic foundation of a prepaid, auditable, addressable platform. That's what is missing. Now, instead of this basic foundation of providing a prepaid, auditable, addressable platform while we were digitizing, we are now trying to fix, which is the basic foundation that is missing, we're trying to repair the second floor of the building by prescribing tariffs between the broadcaster and the platform, and platform and the customer, in a highly hyper-competitive market. We never did that for colas. We never did that for candies. We never did that for soaps. We never did that for shampoos. We did not even do that for telecom. Even telecom works under forbearance today. The entire world sells content by genres. You have children, you subscribe to kids, or you don't. You fond of movies, you subscribe to movies, or you don't. You fond of sports, you subscribe to sports, or you don't. We want to restructure these packages so that the customer will end up paying 3 times what he's paying today for the same bunch of channels that he's having access to today, or he will get 1/3 of the current channels if he were to stay in the same price. Every customer will have to call the operator and select his new package, because the man in the village doesn't have access to an app and doesn't know how to run apps and select and reject these channels. The suggested pricing of the already subsidized box will lead to the kind of subscriber churn that we experienced in 2009, 2010, when 12.5 million boxes of ours were rotated by the trade. We lost them to the winds. An already loss-making company was doing that. Hence, my humble submission is that we need to have some strengthening of the foundation, sir, before we apply any of these disruptions that are being planned. Otherwise, the ones who are already compliant like us will have more compliance to face. And the ones who are not compliant will go scot-free as they did while digitization was being implemented. Thank you very much.